Assalamu alaikum. Today we are having the lecture on Mending Wall by Robert Frost. Robert Lee Frost was an American poet. His work was initially published in England before it was published in America. Known for his realistic depictions of rural life and his command on American colloquial speech, Frost frequently wrote about settings from rural life in New England in the early 20th century, using them to examine complex social and philosophical themes. So if we talk about the early life of Robert Frost, so it was not a good one. He was a dropout of school, and then he worked with his mother, who was teaching adult children. And then Frost wrote a poem which was sold to a newspaper, and it gave him a kind of motivation to write. Frost's grandfather bought a farm, and Frost was supposed to work there. So he worked for 9 years in that farm. And meanwhile, he kept writing, and he wrote many different poems, which were really very good. And it were all set on the scenery that he was looking around. And then after 9 years, he had a very mature expression of writing. Moreover, his farming, it also became successful. Frost then married, and it was a good change in his life. Apart from this, his life was really tragic one. His father died at very early age of Frost, and then his sister, she was mentally retarded. And due to this, she was shifted to mental hospital, where she died eventually. So out of this shock, his mother died too, and she was also suffering from diseases. When Frost had a daughter, so he was shocked to see that even his daughter was retarded. So she too died of this thing. So tragedy of all these things is conspicuous and vividly seen through all his poems and all his themes, especially his loneliness, because he mostly discusses his loneliness in all the poems here. We also find a regional effect in the poetry of Robert Frost, because he's writing about the places where he has spent most of the times, like he spent much of his time in farming. So he writes about the New England and all the settings around. As far as his themes are concerned, we'll first talk about the works. His works have given him Pulitzer Prizes, and he has written hallmark poems which are well known and well loved literary things, and people are in love with his writing. So that is why John F. Kennedy, he attributed him to be the national poet of America. His dominant themes are snow, loneliness, escapism, and conflict. So he talks about conflict in most of his poems. He talks about conflict in theory. He talks about the conflict in practice. He talks about the conflict in the inner and outer conflict of a human being. He talks about inner and outer loneliness. He talks about a conflict in a choice of of going one way or the other. So in every poem, he has depicted the conflict. Escapism of Frost is different from that of Keats. Keats wants to go into escapism and doesn't want to come back. But Frost, on the other hand, wants to escape from the realities for some time. But then he really wants to come back. So if we talk about the achievements of Robert Frost, so 4 times he received Pulitzer Prizes, which is a great achievement on the part of the poet. So first time it was 1924 for New Hampshire, A Poem with Notes and Grace Notes. In 1931 for Collected Poems, thirdly in 1937 for A Further Range, and fourthly in 1943 for A Witness Tree. So this is the credit that goes to Robert Frost. And then he was a poet laureate of Vermont, and 31 times he was a nominee of Nobel Prize. So this is really a credit that is in the pocket of Robert Frost, and this depicts his literary genius and his the beauty of his works and writings. I've already quoted the words of President Kennedy. So he said that Frost was no doubt the national poet of America. So these words of praise come straight from the mouth of the American president. So this is a great credit that goes to Robert Frost. So today we are discussing Manling Wall, which is comparatively a longer poem. This poem is having outer and inner meanings, like apparent and deeper meanings. So we'll be discussing both the meanings in the next slide. Something there is that doesn't love a wall, that sends the frozen ground swell under it, and spills upper boulders in the sun, and makes gaps even two can pass abreast. The work of hunter is another thing. I have come after them and made repair, where they have left not one stone on a stone. But they would have the rabbit out of hiding, to please the yelping dogs. The gaps I mean, no one has seen them made or heard them made. But at spring mending time, we find them there. I let my neighbor know beyond the hill, and on a day we meet to walk the line, and set the wall between us once again. We keep the wall between us as we go, to each the boulders that have fallen to each, and some are loaves and some are nearly so balls. We have to use a spell to make them balance. Stay where you are until our backs are turned. We wear our fingers rough with handling them. So here the poet is talking about something, something mysterious, something which is unseen, something which is not detected in a frequency. So that thing is nature that doesn't love a wall. So he's talking about nature, that something there is that doesn't love a wall, that sends the frozen ground swell under it. Basically, that swells the ground, and when we come after a year or once in a year, when we are coming here to repair, we find that there are gaps and there is ground that is swollen, and it has destroyed the symmetry of the wall. So, and spills the upper boulders in the sun. So, because of that swelling of ground, the big stones which are on the wall, they are now no more in symmetric order. So, some of them fell down and makes gap even two can pass abreast. And so that the wall is so so much having a gap that people can pass through it. The work of hunter is another thing. He says that I'm not attributing it to hunters. Like hunters come and they don't care whose land they're crossing. So they are a part of destruction of the wall, but primarily it is nature that is destroying the wall. He then says that where they have not they have left not one stone on a stone. I have come after them and made repair. So, I have detected that wall is not in symmetric order. So, I have come here again and I see that now that symmetric order of the wall is disturbed and we need to rebuild it. But they would have the rabbit out of hiding to please the yelping dogs. So, it means that when hunters come and when they are losing the dogs to catch the rabbit. So, it is their outdoor sport. So, they don't take care whether they are destroying the fields or not. But he says that the gaps I mean, no one has seen them made or heard them made. That the gaps I am talking about, there are such gaps that are not made in front of any person. No one has detected them or their presence. But at spring mending time, we find them there. But after 1 year, when we come here in spring season, we find the gaps are already there waiting for us. I let my neighbor know beyond the hill. So my neighbor who lives beyond the hill, I tell him that this is a time to work and we need to build a wall or we need to renovate it. And on a day, we meet to walk the line. So we decide a day. And on the day, we meet and we make an inspection of the wall and set the wall between us once again. And once again, we rebuild the wall between each other. We keep the wall between us as we go, and the way we are working together from one end to another end, we are making the wall right. to each the boulders that have fallen to each, and we are putting all the stones which have fallen to the ground, so we are putting them back, and some are loaves and some so nearly balls, some are big stones and some are small stones. We have to use a spell to make them balance, and we are not expert of building, so we need some magic to rebuild the wall in perfect symmetry. Stay where you are until our backs are turned. We wear our fingers rough with handling them. So we are there till the time we make ourselves rough and we are tired. So we keep working all the day, and all the day is spent on building a wall. So here the poet is talking about building or rebuilding of a wall. So poet yahan pe discuss kar rahe ke koi aisi cheez hai jo ke diwaron ko pasand nahi karti. Kabhi kabhi zameen ke andar kuch ubhar aata hai, zameen phoolti hai kahin se, wo naturally kuch hai, matlab earthquake se wo natural hai, zameen ka katao natural hai. To is surat mein zameen kahin se ubhar aati hai, aur zahiri baat hai jab zameen niche se ubregi to upar jo wall bani hai uski symmetry kharab hogi, aur uski symmetry kharab hone se patthar idhar udhar girenge, cracks aayenge, jis tarah aapke ghar ki deewaron mein cracks aa jate hain jab wo dampness ka issue ho ya koi bhi issue ho sakta hai. तो वो कह रहा है कि इसमें इस तरह होता है कि इतना गैप आ जाता है कि लोग अंदर से आसानी से गुजर सकते हैं. हंटर्स भी आते हैं, हंटर्स भी जब गुजरते हैं उन्होंने अपने डॉग्स को छोड़ा होता है रैबिट्स के पीछे, वो भी दीवारों को ख़राब करते हैं. लेकिन ये जिन गैप्स की मैं बात कर रहा हूँ, ये वो गैप्स हैं जिसको किसी ने बनते नहीं देखा, किसी ने सुना नहीं कि गैप्स बन रहे हैं, लेकिन जब हम साल बाद रिपेयर करने आते हैं तो ये गैप्स वहाँ पर मौजूद होते हैं. तो मैं अपने नेबर को बता देता हूँ कि भाई आ जाओ, गैप्स बन चुके हैं, हमें एक दिन इस दीवार को दोबारा देना है. अब ये दीवार कहाँ है? उन दोनों के फॉर्म के दरमियान में है, इन दोनों के घरों के बीच में नहीं है, ये दोनों कहीं और रहते हैं. एक तरफ इसका एप्पल ऑर्चर्ड है, एक तरफ उसके पाइन ट्रीज है. सो उसके दरमियान में ये एक दीवार सेट करते हैं. अब वो दीवार गिरती है हर साल में, तो ये ख़राब होती है, तो ये उसको रिपेयर कर रहे हैं. वो कहता फिर हम दोनों एक एक जगह पर खड़ा होकर पहले इसकी इंस्पेक्शन करते हैं और फिर इसको बिल्ड करना शुरू करते हैं. अब दीवार इतनी टूट चुकी होती है कि हमें लगता है कि हम काश कोई जादू यूज़ कर लें कि हम दीवार को फिर से पहले की तरह बना सकें, और हम सारा दिन लगा देते हैं इस दीवार को बनाने में, हत्ता कि हमारी फिंगर्स तबाह हो जाती हैं, रफ हो जाती हैं, हम यानी बहुत ज़्यादा थक जाते हैं इस एक्टिविटी में. ओह, जस्ट अनदर काइंड ऑफ आउटडोर गेम, वन ऑन अ साइड, इट कम्स टू लिटिल मोर देयर वेयर इट इज़, वी डोंट नीड द वॉल. He is all pine and I am apple orchard. My apple trees will never get across and eat the cones under his spines, I tell him. He only says good fences make good neighbors. Spring is mischief in me and I wonder if I could put a notion in his head. Why do they make good neighbors? Isn't it where there are cows, but here there are no cows. Before I build a wall, I would ask to know, was I walling in or walling out, and to whom I was like to give offense. Something there is that doesn't love a wall, that wants it down. I could say elves to him, but it's not elves exactly, and I would rather he said it for himself. I see him there bringing a stone, grasped firmly by the top in each hand, like an old stone savage armed. He moves in darkness as it seems to me, not of woods only and the shades of trees. He will not go behind his father's saying, and he likes having thought of it so well. He says again, good fences make good neighbors. So here we come to know that the neighbor is adamant that we need to build a wall. So the poet says that, oh, just another kind of outdoor game, one on a side. So the poet believes that they happen to be playing an outdoor game, just like ping pong, table tennis, lawn tennis, badminton, where each player is standing at one place on each side, and there is net in between them. So in this way, it seems like that they are having an outdoor game and there is not a net here, but there is a wall. So they are playing a game. So it comes to little more. The poet says that Now, I have some objection. There where it is, we don't need a wall. So where, as far as our forms are concerned, we don't need a wall actually. He's alpine and I am apple orchard. That why don't we need a wall? Because he has all the trees of pine and I have all the apples here. Like I am having apple orchard and he's having pine trees. So my apples will never get across and eat the cones under his pines, I tell him. I do tell him time and again that this is a fruitless activity that we are doing. That we come once a year here, we rough ourselves, we rough our fingers, our body, and we are perspiring for nothing. And for what we are building a wall, because my apples cannot destroy his pine trees, neither can his pine destroy my apple. So why do we need a wall? I do tell him this thing time and again, but he only says that good fences make good neighbors. That if we have good fences between us, our neighborhood will go better. So spring is mischief in me, and I wonder if I could put a notion in his head. So the poet says that since I am a younger one, so I sometimes create mischiefs, and I tease him saying that why are we building a wall? If we talk about the neighborhood, so neighborhood can be destroyed or can be at danger when we have cows here, when we have animals, like if the neighbor has animal and his animal may penetrate into the form of the poet and destroy it, or if the poet is having an animal or some animals, or they may go and destroy the neighbor's form. He says we don't have any cows, we don't have any animals. And before I build a wall, I would like to ask to know what I was walling in or walling out. Walling in means the poet is protecting himself, walling out means he is giving a protection to his neighbor. So the poet believes in this thing that I am not in danger. So I would like to ask him whether I was, by building this wall, am I protecting myself or am I protecting you? So he says that there is definitely something that doesn't love a wall, that wants it down, and obviously that is nature. I could say elves to him, but it's not elves exactly, and I would rather he said it for himself. So a poet says that I could tell him that it may be the work of some supernatural beings, but the poet knows that it is not the work of any supernatural machinery. But his neighbor is convinced that if every year there is some breakage in the wall, so that must be done by some ghosts or fairies or elves. The poet says, I see him bringing a stone grasped firmly by the top in each hand, like an old stone savage armed. So here the poet compares his neighbor with the prehistoric men who were using stones as arm. So he says that I see him that he's going and collecting big stones in each arm and he's coming back. So he seems to me like old stone savage, a prehistoric ancient person. He moves in darkness, as it seems to me, not of woods only and the shades of tree. So the poet says that when he's collecting stones, he's not only going under the stage, under the shade of trees or woods, he's also going into the shade of darkness. So that darkness refers to the ignorance. So the poet believes him to be an ignorant person in a way, that he is not familiar with the recent trends. So he is lost in old thoughts. So he's ignorant in that kind. He will not go beyond his father's saying, and he likes having thought of it so well. He says again, good fences make good neighbors. So the poet believes that good fences are making good neighbors. Now, here the poet is talking about two different theories. The poet is a younger person, and the old man, his neighbor, he is having some different views which the poet doesn't believe in. So apparently the poem is about building a wall between two forms. But deeper meanings suggest something else. So deeper meanings are about nationalism and internationalism. So the poet is believing in internationalism, and his neighbor, he believes in nationalism. So where there is nationalism, there are walls. Because we are very careful about our nation, about our boundaries. Boundaries are not there in internationalism. For example, if you go to Europe, by having a Schengen visa, you can visit the whole Europe except for UK. So UK is having its nationalism. So Brexit is the example of their nationalism. Then Canada and America, they are visa-free. You can move between those two countries. The wall of Germany has been broken down. So, the poet, the neighbor believes in internationalism, like England, like Pakistan and India, who are not, who cannot tolerate to lose their borders because they are afraid of the cows. So cows here are mischievous elements. Cows here are the terrorist elements, the destructive elements. Poet says we don't have destructive elements, but the neighbor still believes that we should have walls. So if we talk about Pakistan and India, yes, we have cows, we have destructive elements, we have terrorist activities. So that is why we are convinced that we should have walls. And then the poet believes that we should move freely because we are not creating any danger to each other. So is poem mein basically jo poet hai wo young thoughts ka malik hai aur wo internationalism ka qail hai, jo neighbor hai wo boodha hai aur nationalism ka qail hai. Poet kehta hai ki bhai hunters jo hain, hunter yahan pe army ko represent kar rahe hain ki jab jung hoti hai to fir visa nahi dekhte, fir nahi dekhte ki aap kis mulk se guzar rahe hain, fir log mulkon ko runte jate hain. So neighbor ki example isliye. But he believes in nature. Ki nature jo use walls pasand nahi hai. Jab when Adam delved and Eve span, who was then the gentleman? Us waqt koi borders nahi the. To nature ke liye borders aaj bhi nahi hai. Kawwa udega wo Pakistan se India mein chala jayega, wahan se kabutar udega, kabutar pe to bahut mazak bhi bana tha, kabutar Pakistan mein aa jayega. So in cheezon ke liye, insects ke liye, natural objects ke liye, hawa ke liye, suraj ke liye, inke liye borders nahi hai. बॉर्डर्स इंसानों ने अपने लिए बनाए हैं, ख़ासतौर पर उन लोगों ने जो कि नेशनलिस्ट थेरीज के कायल हैं, जो इंटरनेशनलिज्म के कायल हैं, इंग्लैंड यूरोप में लाइक अमेरिका में. सो ये लोग या अरब कंट्रीज स्टेट्स जो हैं, ये लोग इंटरनेशनलिज्म के कायल हैं बिकॉज दे आर फ्री टू मूव फ्राम वन प्लेस टू अनदर. तो वो लोग उधर एक दूसरे की आमदोरफ्त को वेलकम करते हैं क्योंकि उनके पास काउज नहीं है. सो जहाँ पे काउज होती हैं वहाँ पे फिर डिस्ट्रक्शन का ख़तरा होता है. सो मेंडिंग वॉल इज़ ऑल अबाउट अ फ्रूटफुल एंड फ्रूटलेस एक्टिविटी एट द सेम टाइम. कि एक्टिविटी अच्छी भी है बुरी भी है. इफ़ यू हैव सम डेंजर फ्रॉम योर नेबर, सो देन मेंडिंग वॉल इज़ अ गुड थिंग. बट इफ़ यू डोंट हैव एनी डेंजर लाइक इन दिस पोम, तो फिर मेंडिंग वॉल जो है ये एक फ्रूटलेस एक्टिविटी है कि आप साल में एक दफ़ा आके पूरा दिन वेस्ट कर रहे हो. हालांकि ये वॉल नहीं भी होगी तो आपका काम बहुत अच्छा चल रहा है. सो थैंक यू वेरी मच. आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड द पोम. जजाकअल्लाह.